Have you noticed that you're losing strength as you get older? And is that starting to worry you? In this video, I'm going to tell you why that's happening. I'm going to tell you why it matters, and I'm going to tell you what to do about it. So, welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew. Yes, I'm getting older, and yes, I was getting weaker. I reached a stage where I was struggling to open plastic water bottles. But I have been addressing it and I've had fantastic results. And I'm going to tell you why it matters. So let's start off by telling you why it really matters. In terms of studies and signs of potential longevity, so you're more likely on average to live longer, one of the tests is strength. Low strength is a sign of reduced longevity. Okay, the stronger you are, the longer you are likely to live, everything else being equal. The second most significant factor is cardiovascular fitness. So that's your aerobic ability, your endurance ability, so your ability to walk long distances or, hey, run, cycle, any kind of endurance activity. But strength is number one, strength is on top. The third one is muscle mass. Now, muscle mass, in other words, the size of your muscles, the amount of muscle you have, is also a very good sign of health and vitality and longevity. And it can be a proxy for muscle strength. It's not exactly the same thing. You can have big muscles and not be as strong as somebody with slightly smaller muscles, and there are reasons for that, but it's of the theme. Okay, so the vital thing is strength. What is the issue? What is the problem with losing some of our strength? It's not like we're competitive weightlifting or anything. Does it matter if we're not as strong as we used to be? Well, there are several reasons why it does. One is your balance tends to get worse because certain muscles will still be quite strong, other muscles will have become weaker, and now you have an imbalance in the stresses through various parts of your body, particularly your joints, which create balance issues. Those uneven strength stresses through the joints will also cause other issues like arthritis and lead to inflammation, because what happens is you start to compensate for the weak muscle by putting extra strain on somewhere else. And that leads to more pain and even worse balance. So, balance is a big issue when you start to lose muscle strength. That then increases your risk of falling when your balance is not good. And the older you are, the more danger is involved in falling. The more likely it is that you're going to have a life-changing injury, break a hip, break a femur, you don't heal like you used to, and you won't get your mobility back. And the other thing is, of course, you just become less functional. So you have to get people to help you lift things. You can't carry things. You can't move your furniture. You, like me, you're starting to struggle to open jars. And that has an effect on your mental health. You feel dependent on people. You feel you start losing your self-esteem, and you lose your quality of life goes downhill as your mental health goes downhill. So now, why are these things happening? Partly it's age, and there's nothing you can do about it. Well, actually, that's not true. There is nothing you can do about getting older, is what I mean. What you can do is slow down the processes and even reverse them in a lot of cases. So, sarcopenia is a word you may have heard, and it is the wasting away of muscle with age. It's a very normal biological function. But you can slow it down by using the muscles regularly so that they don't waste away. Now, sarcopenia happens because as you get older, your metabolic rate goes down, your hormonal balance changes, you don't produce some of the hormones in the quantities you used to, particularly testosterone, and that slows down muscle repair and new muscle growth. And so your muscles start to waste away. Sarcopenia. It's almost like the use it or lose it rule. And that applies to to all these cases here. The second thing that happens to decrease your strength is your neural pathways, the nerves, the nervous, the web of nerves that goes into the muscles starts to deteriorate because you're not using the muscles anymore. You're not doing the things you used to do when you were younger. And your body says, listen, that's a wasted structure, all that nerve going into that muscle. Let's break that down and let's rather go and focus on something else. And suddenly you become unable to even use those muscles correctly. So it's not that the muscle's gone, it's the nerves. The neural pathway's not there. Then the muscle degrades after that. Again, it's use it or lose it. And the third thing is mobility and flexibility and range of motion. Because you're not doing the things you used to do, you're not running your joints through a wide range of motion like you did when you were younger, your joints become restricted, the range of motion becomes more limited, you then don't exercise those nerves or those muscles to the extent that they were accustomed when you were younger, and again, they break down and deteriorate and you lose your strength. So these are the things that happen. And these things happen because we're not using them. And if we do use them, clearly that is the answer. So what do we need to do? You don't need to go on a boot camp. You don't need to take out a gym membership. You don't need to become Arnold Schwarzenegger and be lifting heavy weights. What you need to be doing is you need to be incorporating resistance exercise, weight-bearing movements in your daily routine. Now that can be from something as simple as using the stairs instead of the lift. It can be when you're out for a walk, getting your cardiovascular exercise in the park. If there's a hill or an embankment or a slope, go up the embankment a few times. If it's like going upstairs. If you are fit enough to go jogging or cycling, put in a few sprints. So you increase the intensity of the exercise and get your muscles working hard. If you are fit enough or inclined to be in a gym, go to the gym. Do some exercises in the gym. Do some weight-bearing exercises, not just walking on the treadmill. Put the treadmill on the slope. Go up the slope. Do some running on the treadmill. Do some weights. Do some light weights. You can do resistance exercises with your own body weight. You don't have to use weights in the gym. Anything like that, any kind of resistance exercise, carrying things around your house, carrying your shopping bags, that is all good strength exercise that is going to stimulate the muscles and stop them from degrading, which will keep you from getting older, and it will keep your balance better and reduce your risk of falling and getting injured. Most people fall when they're old, not because they have bad balance, but because they don't have the strength to catch themselves when they stumble or trip. So standing on one leg as an exercise, yes, it helps you get your balance and that's great. That's not going to stop you falling, because you don't fall because you can't stand up. You fall because you trip on something and you can't react quickly enough and you don't have the strength to catch your body weight as it starts to fall. So strength is absolutely vital. I'm going to link a video underneath here that shows 5 or 6 really, really useful basic exercises that you can do at home 3 or 4 times a week without the need for any special equipment or membership to a group or joining a gym or anything like that. These exercises are very basic, very simple, and extremely effective. You owe it to yourself. Preserve your strength, preserve your muscle mass, your muscle function, and your joint function, and statistically, that will increase your longevity. Thank you for watching. Thank you for liking this video, sharing this video, and applying this video to yourself to make yourself fitter, stronger, healthier, and younger. If you enjoy our videos and you get benefit from the content of our videos, you really should consider joining our club. So if you click the join button below this video, or the link that I'm going to put in the video description, you can find out more about being a member of the Shape Fixer Club and how we can help you on your journey towards health and reversing the aging process.